Hello, welcome to DocTuber. We all love pizzas, right? Delicious. Or burgers, a bite of burger. You are licking your lips. Or the delicious French fries, we love them all. And the kebabs, the magnificent kebabs, the flavors of which makes us mad. But wait, what we are eating? We are eating advanced glycation end products. So what is it and how does it affect our body? We'll answer all these questions. Stay tuned to our channel. We all love bread toasts, right? But too much toasting will make you age faster. Let's know why. Now, a chemical reaction takes place during cooking at high heat. That is known as Maillard reaction. Here, sugars and proteins of the food react to form advanced glycation end products, which give flavors to the food. Apart from exogenous supply of AGs from cooked food, it can also form inside our body. Due to increase in blood sugar levels in our body due to diabetes or intake of carbohydrate-rich foods like cake, grains and chocolates, AG can be formed within our body. Increased sugars in our body attaches to various proteins, causing the formation of early glycation products, and over weeks, slowly, there is formation of cross-linked structural proteins called advanced glycation end products. Now, what's the wrong if we take too much AGs? Now, AGs are abundant in modern diet. When AGs enter the blood circulation, it binds to AG receptor called RAGE, and this triggers inflammatory response in our body. It activates nuclear factor kappa B, resulting in release of inflammatory cytokines, which causes various diseases like allergy and autoimmune disease, neurodegeneration, cardiovascular diseases, cancer, eye disorders, diabetes and insulin resistance, endocrine disorders like thyroid dysfunction, and various gastrointestinal disorders. So let's know them in details. AGs can lead to various chronic diseases, and it is the major cause of inflammation in our body. For instance, in heart, it causes stroke, hypertension and heart failure. AGs damage vascular endothelium and also promotes atherosclerosis. AGs cause inflammation in kidneys and it leads to renal fibrosis and chronic kidney disease. AGs cause liver damage by activating hepatic stellate cells, which causes liver fibrosis. Many of us suffer from stomach ulcers, which is because AGs causes damage to gastric epithelium, causing gastritis and ulcer. AGs can also cause damage to lungs. It causes lung fibrosis and also chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. AGs can cause various types of brain disorders, like it can cause stroke, it can lead to Alzheimer's disease and also Parkinson's disease. AGs also damage small intestines and large intestines. It causes inflammatory bowel disease and also it can cause colon cancer. So we have seen that how AGs can cause majority of our chronic disorders. So it is very important to decrease the intake of AGs. So we can decrease the intake of AGs via decreasing the consumption of processed foods, grilled, fried and roasted foods. Now we have to use high moisture cooking techniques and we have to marinate meat and fish in low pH solution before cooking to reduce AGs. Cooking technique involving low heat and steaming is the ideal way to reduce AGs in food. We should avoid prolonging the duration of cooking of food. It reduces the amount of AGs in the food and also it preserves the vital nutrients like vitamins in the food. While cooking meat and fish, we should marinate it with vinegar and lemon juice to reduce the formation of AGs. Here, you can check out which food items have very low AG levels, which has low and which has medium levels of AG. For example, vegetables and fruits have minimum AG levels. In this diagram, we can see that foods like burgers, sausage and pizza have maximum amount of AGs. So avoiding this food is key to maintain good health. Turmeric, which contains curcumin, can be of great benefit in preventing damages from AGs. Curcumin breaks down the cross-linking proteins in AGs and thus helps in preventing inflammation. Now let's summarize what we have discussed today. Now AGEs are formed when extra sugar binds with either protein or fat. Endogenous AGEs are formed inside the body, while exogenous AGEs are formed during cooking. Anti-AGE diet must include vegetables, fresh fruits, whole grains and milk. We should avoid cooking at high temperature in dry heat, and we should cook in moist heat at a low temperature for a shorter duration of time. Thanks for watching our video. Please do like, share and subscribe, and see you in next episode.